It was a qualifying campaign that always glowed with a collective spirit, but it was illuminated by a guiding light. It caught fire because of one player, Gareth Bale.
He's a special player, and he can make the difference in any game.
Every single training session and every game, there's definitely a Gareth Bale moment where you just think, wow.
When Gareth Bale is in full flow, he is unstoppable. Simple as that.
You could put him on the pitch anywhere you like, then he'd be an outstanding player. Just give him the ball. He'll do something with it. It's a certainty.
He's come up with the goods time and time again, and that illustrates what an outstanding player he is.
Qualifying now gives way to the real thing.
The impact that he can have, I mean, he's one of the best players in the world.
He's the match winner, he's the main man, he's a talisman of the team.
He is ours, but his time with us is limited. We have to share him with the club, never afraid to spend like no other. If only it were as simple as playing, doing what he does best. But this is life as an £85 million Galactico. And when you join the mega wealthy of Real Madrid, you enter a new world. At the age of 26, you're a long way from the end of your journey, but you're also a long way from where you started. Little Gareth Frank Bale, from the northern suburbs of Cardiff. He went to school here, Whitchurch High, a huge comprehensive, and home to a special sporting elite. Rugby's Sam Warburton and cyclist Geraint Thomas went here too. Did the footballer stand out? Spot the Bale in a sea of faces.
He was quiet, got about his work quietly, didn't really upset too many people, easy to get along with, he was the kid who was good at football, Give the ball to Bale, that's probably our main call. If he didn't play, we didn't win.
A guiding light already then, and one soon on his way. Talent spotted by the Southampton Academy, and not long afterwards, by the Saints' first team manager.
Gareth was always somebody that people were speaking about. Fabulous left back at the time. Young player with bags of energy, enthusiasm. And I had no fears of giving Gareth his opportunity. Got into the first team and never looked back.
There was still something of the age of innocence about all this. A game simply to be enjoyed. But this was also a fast track. The next manager to be impressed. John Toshack, manager of Wales, a child prodigy in his day, but not as young as this.
Gareth Bale becomes Wales' youngest ever international. 16 years and 315 days. Wales celebrated wonder kid.
Late May 2006, a friendly against Trinidad and Tobago in Graz, Austria. Not quite home, but looking very much at home.
Good ball through for Bale here, and return to Archer, and it might just have won the game.
Gareth Bale, record breaker. How does that feel?
Yeah, obviously, it's good, yeah. Enjoyed every minute of the game and just happy to get on, really, yeah.
What's it been like the last couple of days with the senior squad?
Well, obviously, it's just a new experience for me and just enjoy every minute of it, just being around all the big players and that.
The next landmark. A first goal for Wales in 2008. Things to do in football. Tick them off one by one. Celebrate them. All preparation for what started in September 2014. Wales hadn't qualified for the finals of a major championship since 1958. Here lay the great challenge.
I think, the start of qualifying, he realised that something was possible. And he thought to himself, I really need to perform in the qualifying and do the best I can to get this team over the line.
Not the best of starts.
Davis, Bale is waiting. Bale with a header! 1-1! Gareth Bale comes to the rescue in the nick of time for Wales!
It wasn't the greatest of starts, but we showed true character in the squad to keep going and come back.
The good thing I like about people like Gareth Bale is they look as if they want to play, they look as if they're going to be out there every time, give 100%. You know, hopefully, he'll be in that Welsh team for years and years to come.
The shaky start, followed by two draws and a victory. After four games, Wales were unbeaten. A win away in Haifa against Israel, and they'd go to the top of their group.
Bale hits it! 2-0!
Ramsey inside the Israel area, tries to get it back to Bale, and he scored a second tonight! Gareth Bale makes it Israel 0, Wales 3!
What he does as a world-class player is he has the ability to change games, and he's done that on numerous occasions for Wales, being the difference in key games when you need your big players to produce, because that's the demand everybody places on the top players, and he's come up with the goods time and time again, and that's illustrates what an outstanding player he is.
Back in May 2007, when he was still 17, he was on the move again, from Southampton to Tottenham Hotspur. He went for millions, but only single-figure millions.
Made the right decision. It's obviously a big club, just a lot of potential, and hopefully we can fulfil that, and hopefully I can be a part of it.
Almost immediately at Spurs, he was more than just a part of it.
You could see from day one with Gareth that he was special. Did I think that he would get to the heights that he's got to? I mean, I think to say that you wouldn't be surprised, you'd probably be lying. He was always a very confident lad. You could tell that he had the ability on and off the pitch.
There had to be a stumble somewhere, a trip up. For a time, it all went wrong. There was a succession of injuries.
I did feel, you know, he'd get a little knock in training, and then I can see him now limping off on one leg, you know, two or three times every morning when someone would kick him. Because I suppose the only way you could stop him would be to kick him, you know, he was unstoppable. And I said to the physios, just leave him, he'll get up. You know, and then suddenly he sort of came through that spell.
I was still a young boy at the time, and there's obviously certain aspects I needed to improve, and I worked hard in training and kind of proved to him that I was worthy of a spot in the team, and when I did that, he gave me my chance.
A fresh start. A turning point. A Champions League game against Inter Milan. Spurs 3-0 down at half-time.
I said, no, listen, you know, I'm not taking Gareth off. If we get a goal or two, I'm not saying I ever felt we could win the game, but I certainly felt, you know, we had to be some kind of a threat going forward. In the second half, I mean, he scored the most amazing hat-trick.
2013. He was a headline act now. Would he be any different as a person?
4 days off last week because I felt, you know, he needed a break because he'd been playing so well and working so hard. I said, go, I brawled for a few days, and he did. He went to Cardiff and we stayed at his mum's.
Bale shoots! Oh, he's got it! I don't believe it!
In his last season for Spurs, he scored 26 goals in all competitions.
He's an incredible, talented player. He's a genius, really, when the ball's at his feet. He's one of the best players I've ever sort of even seen, you know, live. When he's on the ball, he's just like a gazelle, you know, he's so quick.
The PFA's Players' Player of the Year, their Young Player of the Year, and the Football Writers' Player of the Year. He was a target. They loved him at home, and they came after him from abroad. And one club in particular could afford him.
Gareth Bale va a ser presentado este mediodía en el Santiago Bernabéu.
Рекордную сумму за футболиста заплатил мадридский клуб.
He was the talk of Europe.
Dernier transfert. Voici le journaliste.
It was always going to be difficult to hang on to him. But in the end, Tottenham got incredible money for him, and it was a great move for him to Real Madrid. So it was, you know, I probably suited everybody. He was irreplaceable at Tottenham, though. That was the problem.
Well, I think at the time was one of those players that really were important. I think with Benzema already here, Messi, Neymar, Suarez for Barcelona, Bale was just that player in the top five or top six you can get. And in the end, I think he came because he wanted to.
Yeah, I always wanted to try and reach the peak of anything, and I think Real Madrid is that. For me, they're the biggest club in the world. I always wanted to strive to be the best, and I always wanted to play for Real Madrid.
Of course, the fans were excited too, because it's not just that it's the Premier League, it's that Spanish football fans watch English football a lot. They're aware of players in the Premier League. This isn't a guy that, you know, you look at the stats and you go, oh, he scored a lot of goals. No, we've seen him score a lot of goals, and in that sense, yeah, he was a very big target.
What the fans know in Madrid is matched by what they expect.
Digamos que el Bernabéu es como un tribunal que sabe mucho de fútbol y por lo tanto para los jugadores en un principio es un placer jugar en un estadio como el Bernabéu, 80.000 personas, todos los partidos está lleno, pero al mismo tiempo la exigencia, el nivel de exigencia es muy alto.
The weight of the price tag, the pressure of those demands. How would the 24-year-old from Cardiff react to this intensity in Madrid, a Galactico among so many other Galacticos?
When he was at Spurs, he was pretty much running the show, and going to Madrid, obviously playing with the likes of the Ronaldos, the Benzemas, the Modrics who he's played with before, he's not so much the main man now, but he'd be learning so much off those players and playing in that type of environment.
I feel I've settled in well now. I think it was a lot more difficult at the start, but half of the players spoke very good English. I obviously knew Luka Modric from Tottenham. Cristiano obviously speaks English, which helped me settle in a lot easier. But I come in, I was excited to be there, wanted to prove myself, and they're a great bunch of lads. They made me feel very welcome straight away.
He's a fantastic player, fantastic talent, and I think my experience with him in Real Madrid was really good, because I think it's not easy for a player that comes in another country. But the first year he did really, really well, and he showed fantastic quality.
Real Madrid have been obsessed with winning the 10th European Cup for over a decade.
cambio, pero yo creo que en general es un jugador muy querido porque es muy buen jugador, sin duda.
But doubts tend to hang around. The rumour started that there was friction between the Welshman and the Portuguese megastar Cristiano Ronaldo.
Inside the locker room of Real Madrid, you cannot find many Ronaldo friends. I mean, because Ronaldo is like an independent republic inside the locker room. Probably he has only one, two close friends, not many.
Normal, the media tries to create something that's not there, and we've said many a times, both of us, that we get on fine, we get on well, and the most important thing is the football, and we try and win games and trophies.
There's a great comment from Cristiano Ronaldo earlier this year when he was asked about the way that Neymar, Suarez and Messi get on, and clearly very good friends, and why doesn't this happen with Bale, Benzema and Ronaldo, and he said we don't need little hugs and little kisses to prove that we get on.
I think Gareth has had to learn the hard way. I think that last year in Madrid and going through that experience of the fans being a little bit up and down after being so pro-Gareth, I think he would have grown as a player and as just as a man, really.
The game of contrasts. White and red, struggle and glory, Spain and Wales. Thinking of home can help.
I always had the thought that I had an opportunity in 2-3 weeks or whenever it was, to go back and play for Wales, and that always sustained me, even when sometimes I was out there, wasn't playing particularly well, or things, a little bit of press going against you, which at times it's gone against Gareth as well. He always had that thing in the back of your mind, so well, I've got a Welsh game coming up, and that used to get you back on track.
And it's not just home for the big occasion. Little surprise visits.
Who's probably hit the best shot that you could think of?
Bale. Of course, you always miss home. Home's home, and you can never change that. And whenever I get the chance to go home, I always do. Hi, guys. Aww. Do you mind if I join in?
Yeah.
It's something I enjoy doing. I like giving back to the community. It's great to see kids obviously enjoying their football. And if I can help in any way, that's what I try to do.
I think when he meets up with international boys, no one there thinks, oh my God, it's Gareth Bale, the superstar who plays for Real Madrid. You think he played down the road for Cardiff City or Swansea City. That's just how he is. He's very down to earth. And that's a difficult thing, because I think, you know, when you have amazing things happen to you, like playing for one of the best clubs in the world, playing in the Premier League, that those kind of things can change you as a person, but not him.
Back to the more straightforward story of qualifying for the Euros. Or was it? A win in Zenica against Bosnia-Herzegovina and Wales were through. Simple. But they lost 2-0. And then heard that Cyprus had just won in Jerusalem.
That result in Israel means the celebrations can still start. Wales will be in France next summer.
Everybody knows how much it means to me to play for Wales, and to create history for the country and to qualify is obviously something special.
Just for once, there was a game without strain. The final group game against Andorra in Cardiff. A qualifier with qualification already settled. Party time.
Low ball into the penalty area. Gareth Bale! Oh, Gareth Bale! Troy Queen! He got Alisson Point!
It's been a long process, but I think obviously the credit goes to mostly to Chris Coleman. I think he's really pushed us on and made us really kick on and have that belief in ourselves. Over the years, we've grown together, we've grown more experienced, we've got used to how international football is played, and I think that's showing now. We've got all the experience behind us, and we're all been together for such a long time. We get on really well. We know each other's games, and We all fight for each other on the pitch. We all feel like brothers. We all work for each other. And the bond we have as a group in the changing rooms and in the hotels is nothing like I've seen before. And I think it's a big reason why we're doing well.
Things to do in football. Safely tuck away a penalty and win the Champions League again. This was a performance that had its cramp, its worries for Wales. But that was consummate and ended a marathon in Milan with smiles all round. All is well in Spain.
Luego la relación que tengo con él es muy muy buena, muy buena porque es un chico muy muy sencillo. Es que es un jugador muy muy importante para el equipo, él lo sabe, pero si como es joven todavía puede mejorar.
Confiamos en que, insisto, sea un jugador fundamental para nosotros en los próximos años y que deje aquí una huella para siempre en este club. Desde luego que estamos hablando de un jugador que marca las diferencias. Cuando él está bien, muy pocos jugadores en el mundo con esa capacidad.
I'm sure he's going to be here for a long time. I hope so. He can be one of those stars that fans will remember in the future for a long time. And that would be fantastic for him and also for the club.
Things to do in football. Play for your country in the finals of a major championship. And hang on every name coming out of the draw. L'Angleterre.
In pot number one, Angleterre.
L'Angleterre.
England.
Wales.
Wales.
Russia and Slovakia came out of the hat too. But the second round in Group B comes with a tingle. Wales against England. In the old coal city of Lens.
Probably the biggest game in the tournament so far. I think if you're looking at the fixture list and one we're all excited for. We know it's going to be a difficult game. England are a very good side as well as ourselves. So we'll be going into it, looking forward to it, trying to enjoy it, and hopefully we can get the win.
Lens, not too far into France, beyond the Channel Tunnel, where England will have to contain Gareth Bale.
I don't know how they're going to cope with him. I imagine this is a conversation that most clubs have had over a number of years. Because he's not just quick and strong, because he's got the ability to hit shots from 25, 30 yards, he can adapt his game to any way of trying to stop him.
Bale all the way, never in doubt.
So, I'm really not sure, actually. I worry for them a little bit now I've just spoke about it.
The taming of the Bale. If you can't beat him.
Look, there's a very easy way to get me to play for your team.
How?
Support Wales. Can't do any worse than England.
Support Wales. Gareth, I am a proud Englishman. Support Wales.
I've never heard anything more preposterous in my life. Three lines on a shirt, mate. That's me. Gareth, I was only joking.
Will be more difficult to be competitive, but he brought his nation to play the European Cup, and I think Bale can do a fantastic Euro.
He is a special player, and he can make the difference in any game. Suddenly Gareth gets on it and bang, 25, 30 yards, he can pick one out in the top corner, or go and beat two or three players. He can change everything in a flash, and to have that in your team is a real bonus.
You'll be seen as one of the major players in the tournament, I'm sure. He's one of the top five, six best players in the world for me. So, everyone's going to be looking to him in the tournament to see what he does.
Every single training session and every game, there's definitely a Gareth Bale moment where you just think, wow,
You know, that he's superhuman at times. You know, it's nice to be on the same pitch as him at sometimes. And you think back to some of the things he's done with Wales, you know, some of the games he's played, some of the goals he's scored. It's just, it's unbelievable. You know, he's the top level.
He's one of the best players in the world. I think it all depends on how that Wales team play to his strengths. You know, I think if they can just get the ball to him as much as they can and defend as well as they can, Gareth will do the rest.
He could light the Euros up. If he gets space and he gets time to run at the opposition, whether it's England, whether it's Barcelona, whether it's whoever, Gareth Bale can win any game of football because he's a genius.
We're not going there just to make up the numbers. We want to win every game that we play. We want to win the group. We want to give ourselves the best chance. So no matter who we play, we feel confident in our abilities that we can win, and we'll go out there to try and do that.
And you can head over to BBC Radio Wales right now. Rob Phillips and Aleri Sean host a Euro 2016 sing-along with the BBC National Orchestra and Chorus of Wales. Come on, Wales is just about to start.